Now, before adopting the Senate version, the lower house approved its own bill granting President Rodrigo Duterte additional powers to respond to the COVID-19 outbreak in the country. Let's get more details on that. House Ways and Means Committee Chairperson Joey Salceda joins us on the line. Good morning, Congressman, and thank you for joining us.
Yeah, good morning.
Okay, first I'd like to ask, how soon will the promised benefits under this additional powers, especially the budgetary powers granted to President Duterte, how soon will they be felt in terms of actual programs and projects on the ground?
Actually, kasi na-derive lang yung, essentially, ano ba yung kailangan gawin? So, anong kailangan natin? We have to give... To support people's compliance to the quarantine, and therefore, the quarantine is starving the virus, but it is also starving the people. So, ang kailangan po talaga ma-supportahan natin yung mga pangangailangan nila dahil sambuan po sila yung mga kapagtrabaho kaya wala po silang income. Makikita mo kagad din dito sa chart, no? Yung halos 40% po ang reduction po ng power consumption dito po sa Luzon. So yung mga peak, there's one chart which shows that yung, there's been some, I think, significant compliance by the people. By the way, you look at commercial consumption of power as well as, of course, the industrial consumption of power. So I think, so importante na masuportahan natin yan para po kung makita po ng tao na sila sila supporta, and I think they will not break the quarantine. So yung resulta po ng analysis na yon says that we need to support the people, and therefore how to support them, they need special powers for the president, and since Congress will come back only on by May 4, and by that time baka marami ng patay at marami ng kaso, so we needed to do it quickly, so to do a special session essentially to the first time in the whole world to an online special session. So yan po yung parang milieu ng itong pong special powers for the president. So, essentially, gives it the power to realign the budget of 2019 kasi it's still actually nandiyan pa siya in extend natin at saka yung 2020. So he can easily raise about 275 billion that, and almost the whole thing will be essentially gagastusin po para sa pagbibigay po ng cash subsidy at almost 73% of the entire nation, the entire fund, all family, 24.6. That is at 8,000, or meron din po yung mga dati na meron 5,000. So mga 5 to 8,000 po ang cash subsidy. How quickly can we do it? I think kasi alam na natin po yung mga 4Ps, easily po, kaya i-download po yun sa DSWD, then non-bank, then nasa bank account na po nila. Tapos yung UCT naman po, ito yung mas malaki, ito yung mga 10 million. So at least we have about, kailangan po natin 13.5 million, yun po ang kailangan po ng mga buyers contributing para po makating sa kanila agad. Kasi kung titingnan nyo, na-establish natin yung lockdown, okay? And then number two, kinasiguro po yung food supply chains. Kaya malinis po ba ang takbo? So, ang ating po mga supermarkets are well-supplied. Our domestic manufacturers are actually going back to their normal yung capacity nila nandyan. So ang importante na lang po ay yung buying capacity. May two-allowance choice ka. Ibili mo yung mga tao o ang mga tao bigyan mo ng konting oras para mamili. Of course, the strategy is bigyan sila ng oras tulad po sa Wuhan where one in every family is given the chance every other day to buy their
Congressman,
food.
Clarification lang. How much is the total package of this included?
275 yun eh.
That's a total? Okay.
Yeah, they can raise 275 kasi yung nilagay naman doon that they can realign and reprogram.
Okay. Another question is, some people are concerned that this might violate the Supreme Court ruling on the Disbursement Acceleration Fund.
Yung kasi walang congressional action.
Okay.
At saka pangalawa, yung pondong gagamitin ay pondo naman po ng executive. Ang pinagbabawalan lang konstitusyon, kung hindi ka makapag-saving, kasi in short, i-reprogram ng presidente, sabihin niya na ito isang project na kinakancel, and therefore can be declared a savings, and therefore yung savings na can augment a new program. It's very clear na yung mga new programs pertain to the COVID. I look at that constitutional angle. I think makakapasapot.
Pero in this case, don't you need to redefine savings just to accommodate this particular realignments under this bill?
I think yung existing definition of savings makukomply po ng presidente para po namin. But essentially, we're giving them a parang blanket authority to cancel or suspend certain projects, and therefore use the savings there, and then realign it basically. So yung power is being given the power to realign. It is supposed to be with Congress, and then pinibigay namin po sa kanya.
Oh, nga.
Kasi may emergency.
Mm-hmm. Pero for example, are the provisions included in the special powers bill when it comes to the budget, are they specific enough to make sure that there won't be possible abuses when it comes to discretion?
Meron naman po doon na unang-una, lahat yan dapat para sa COVID response. At ang alawa, wala naman po tayo 4 years na experience ng mga DAP o PDAP o yung mga na-induced mga issues na gano'n. So, pangatlo, meron naman pong oversight committee na tinatalaga, tapos pinapag-report naman po siya lagi. At pangatpat, 2 months lang naman ang holdo, yung 2 months pwede pong tumagal.
Okay, now is there...
Depende po kung tumagal din po yung COVID sa atin.
Now, is there something in the bill that would benefit small businesses when it comes to, let's say, state subsidies? Or would that be covered by another bill?
Which one?
Yung state subsidy, let's say, to small businesses, people working in the tourism sector, basically stimulus.
Nandun, pero hindi kakayanin po yung pera na marirace nito.
Oh, yun nga.
So, nakapag-file na rin po ako nung bill na yun, actually, 6619. And essentially, it gives $300 billion for business recovery program for SMEs as well as for big business. Essentially, it is based po sa pinaka-central measure, then it's $300 billion for negative interest rate loan.
How much is that again? 200?
Kumpanya na mag-retain po.
Congressman, how much is that again, your proposed measure?
300.
Magkano?
300, that's even before Jokmo, no? The central bank.
300 billion? How much?
Yes, for negative interest rate loans. So, yung mga kumpanya po at mga SMEs na nag-retain po ng kanilang tao, pwede po silang umutang either na yung may magbabayad pang gobyerno ng 300 billion na pwede pong utak kasi meron na dito po sa emergency powers, pwede na po kumbaga dati inalis na po natin yung direct credit lending as part ng government economic activity. Ngayon, binabalik natin yun. Pero mas maganda yung conduit pa rin sila ang bank at saka sa DPP. Magpapautang sila. So, alam, ikaw, marami ka pong hindi mo niretain mo po yung tao mo. So, 50% ng total labor cost mo for 1 year.
Okay.
Yun po ang amount. So, imbis na i-decide sa loan, tapos imbis na magbayad ng interest, magbabayad ka ng negative interest. Ibig sabihin, kung 100 million yun, nababayaran mo lang 90 million pesos.
So, Congressman Salceda, just to clarify, so this 275 billion package that is included in the bill that was
Bayanihan
Act. So this will just be the opening salvo. You would still need additional funding to finance, let's say, subsidies.
Yeah, tama po kaya. Definitely, yun ang isang weakness ng Bayanihan Act. Kasi nga, hindi in-increase yung parang walang supplemental. Kasi kumaga, kinuha mo lang yung mga existing. So in other words, there may be some increase of deficit because of the 2019 and 2020 combination. But essentially, yung budgetary ceiling is still there. ano pinapost ng presidente noong 2019 saka noong 2020, eh, may konti lang naman talaga sa 2019. Mm-hmm. So basically, yung 2020 budget ceiling, yun po ang dun po namin i-cut itong 275. And that's because yung 150 ng 275 is actually from GOCCs.
Oh.
So i-reprogram lang po.
Oh, and then what happens to the existing contingency fund? Because some people are saying, some of your colleagues are saying that...
Kaya dun sa house, actually, at least mga 100 lang naman, meron naman siyang naka-FLR na o for later release. Remember the budgetary issue last for 2020 na may 80 billion na hindi na binito.
Yeah. Mm.
Pero for later release, so 80 kagad yun. So 20 billion lang. So pag titingnan mo naman doon, meron ang dating 35 billion na UCT. At pangalawa, meron pong dati ng, already sila dagala rin na, na 85 billion also for CCP. So, kasi itong, ito ang dalawang central programs talaga na magpapatakbo ang kasi panggagalingan, itatop up lang po siya nung marirace po. So, basically po, if at all, yung affected, ay mga 20 billion lang po dun sa mga existing. So ang sinasabi ng report dito na sabi na ito ay within 2 years ay papadungin pa rin ng gobyerno.
Okay.
So yun na notwithstanding
Congressman, yung operational cost of let's say making sure that yung operational cost nung because you have 18 million families that would benefit from Opo. This cash transfer basically, diba, between 5,000 and 8,000 included that yung Opo. Top up dun sa existing CCT budget Opo. That they are receiving. Magbabago ba let's say yung operational cost ito in terms of distribution or it will just be the same?
Yung sa CCT wala masyado kasi DSW nila itatap up nga lang, tatap out lang yan. Tapos yung UCT naman, may 2 years na tayong 2018, 2019. Meron na tayo experience, dumaan na rin po yun, kumaga na season na rin yung ano yan na nagbibigay po ng 10 million. So essentially 10 million, sakto na po ang ano natin. We have already, kumaga, nandun na lang yung tubo at nandun na po yung mga gripo. So papasukin mo lang yung tubig, at least for the 10 million of the 18 million. Kasi hindi lang naman Metro Manila po yung pagbibigyan nito kasi marami po talaga nagsaktan pag lockdown ng Luzon. So I think national siya in character, not just those of them. Iuunahin po yung mga nasa NCR kasi mga naka-lockdown.
Mm-hmm.
Kasi baka mag-break ng quarantine yung mga tao pag nakita nila na siyempre gutom at kailangan nila po makapag-survive.
Okay, now Congressman, ang the total package that was approved by the House, 275 billion. But that only covers 2 months. Actually, ang tanong ko is let's say
that ang 275 sinasabi ko based po sa assessment po ng DOF na yun po ang marirace.
Okay.
All these ito yung masisave. Ito yung magagastos.
Oh, my question is, this is only good for 2 months, but what if the quarantine is extended?
I think given all the stimulus that has been done all across the world, like the U.S. is doing a 10% stimulus, $2 trillion. So this is roughly still a non-stimulus to the extent that it is merely realigning and using the same budgetary ceiling. So effectively po, wala pa, kumbaga, we are still not yet, kumbaga, on the philosophy beneath the emergency powers that we are not yet there and we're trying to take a preemptive strike para po na actually makikita mo naman that the lockdown is actually working by using just yung effect niya po sa energy consumption. So hopefully na this can limit the infection, limit the death, as well as of course enable a quicker recovery for the economy. I think the kung lumampas po dyan, nandito naman po sa nandito naman na 2 months thereafter, although we might need a new supplemental budget, but by that time, that 1 month, we will be in Congress already.
Okay. So you might still need a supplemental budget. So
oh,
basically, ito, ano lang, pasok pa rin to.
I already filed a supplemental budget. That's I also call, you know, Filipino first. So, kasi ito pala raw. Filipino family first. Pero yung akin, sana mas simple. Bigyan na lahat ng, kasi ang dami pong ano, sources of entitlement. OFW ka ba? Space ka ba ng COVID?
Congressman, one final question. I'd like to get your thoughts on this because yesterday some of your colleagues flashed a banner, I mean a paper with the words, "Together with doctors and frontliners, we went to work for you, so please stay at home for us." Including the Speaker of the House and some cabinet members were heavily criticized on social media because of that message. Do you think that was something that your colleagues and some members of the cabinet should have done or should not have done?
I think, ako naman kasi, maganda naman yung gagawin ng House dito eh. Talagang for the first time sa buong mundo, nagkaroon ko na online or digital, online ano eh, session. Para lang po, kasi kung tinintay namin ng May 4, hindi namin ginawa yung kahapon. And obviously, it will break the quarantine. The quarantine supposed to starve the virus and it will starve the people. By doing this, then we can keep the people in quarantine and at the same time be able to meet their daily needs. Yung soft med bashing is, of course, is a powerful force. In other words, in a different menu probably or setting, the reaction may not be as negative. It only came because after na yung mga senador ko they went ahead of the queue, and basically there was a sort of backlash on the feeling of entitlement, and therefore kaya yung kahapo parang naging rubbing the wound, so to speak.
I think kasi congressman, it's like some congressmen and some cabinet members were tapping themselves on the back, diba? Praising themselves for something that they were supposed to do, and worse, they were comparing their job, their action to the actual frontliners. Para bang dinagdagan pa ng drama.
Depende naman kasi po yun eh. The SOCMED world is that world is pero ang importante po we were doing something really good and it was the right thing to do, and I think in fact I would say that approving that is patriotic in a sense. So I don't know how far depende po sa sitwasyon po ng audience. Pero sa pananaw ko, basta sigurado kang tama at may kabutihan at yun ang kinakailangan ko ng sitwasyon. Yung ano na lang para sa akin to eh. I'm not saying it's irrelevant, but rather there was no conscious effort really to further.
Okay.
Kasi nakadagdag lang po yun dun sa issue po ng PIP testing.
Okay. Well, thank you very much, Congressman Joey Salceda, for taking our call this morning.
Maraming. Good morning po sa lahat.